Welcome back guys, welcome back to my channel. In this video, I will show you guys how I created these cool abstract designs in Adobe Illustrator. All of these are achieved in the same way, same concept. Before we start, let's see our sponsored message first. You guys can sell these type of artworks in marketplaces. You can sell as a whole artwork or even sell these individual shapes separately, or even you can change the colors or lighting and sell the same artworks as bundles. So you guys may think, where can you sell your artworks? And if you are a beginner, will your artwork will be accepted in an online marketplace? So that's where Master Bundle comes in. Today's tutorial video is brought to you by Master Bundle. If you are a beginner or an experienced designer, or even if you are selling your artworks in other stores or marketplaces, Master Bundle is one of the best place for you guys to sell your artwork exclusively or even non-exclusively. In Master Bundle, the priority feature is focused on promoting and creating design collections, which are called bundles. So this is a great opportunity for you guys to sell you a new or old standalone product and combine them into design collections and sell as bundles. As new designers and beginners, you don't have to have a lot of design works. You can start with 3 to 5 pieces of sets. You can sell vector art, presentation templates, fonts, web layout designs, and many more. You will get 50% commission for each sale. Check out masterbundle.com for more details. Link is under description below. Alright guys, first let's create a document. I'm going to create 1000 by 1000 for this example. You guys can create any size you want, but keeping it as a square is easier for you to design. Next, I'm going to create the background. For this, I'm going to select the rectangle and click on the artboard. In here, I'm going to enter 1000 width and 1000 height, so it will cover our entire artboard. And then let's just center this to the artboard. Okay, now let's prepare the colors for this artboard. You guys can have any colors, but for this I'm going to create some random rectangles, boxes in here, and select some colors from here. Okay, go to the color palette in here, fill color, and I'm just going to select some colors randomly. In here, I'm going to select a darker tone for the background, and these two colors will be our line colors, which is going to be a gradient. All right, now let's select the rectangle, our background rectangle, and apply the darker tone. And we can lock this layer by pressing on Ctrl 2. Next, I'm going to select the ellipse in tools and click on the artboard, which will open up the ellipse dialog box in here. And for this, I'm going to enter 100 by 100 for the width and height. Okay, now select the ellipse and go to the stroke color. Make sure you don't apply any fill color for this ellipse. Only apply a stroke color and change the stroke color to gradient. Now with the default gradient selected in here, go to the gradient panel. Make sure you have selected the stroke and change these gradients to RGB, or you can directly select this color picker and pick the colors you have designed earlier. Okay, one side I have selected the bright red tone, the other side I have selected this purple color. All right, now we can go to the stroke width in here and increase the stroke width to 15. Okay, now you guys can see our selected two color gradient has been applied to this stroke. Now this point, make sure your circle has been centered to the artboard. This step is very important. If not, our next steps won't work properly for this design. Okay, next, go to your toolbox and select the scissor tools. And make sure in the view, snap to points, and your smart guides are on. Now with the scissor tool, go to the circle and select the point on top. We have 4 points in here, and cut it once. Same with the bottom point in here. Now we have divided this circle into two shapes. And you guys can see the gradient also applying to them individually. Now we can select them both and go to this gradient panel and adjust the gradient the way we want. Okay, we can also change the colors in here. It will apply to both of these shapes. But if you guys notice the gradient which we have applied here, it's not applying properly the way we want from the example you guys saw earlier. We want the gradient to be end to end, start from one side, end in the other side. Go along with the path. So we can change that very easily. All we need to do is select these two, and in the gradient panel, you can see below the gradient type, we can select the apply gradient along path option, which will apply the gradient end to end like this. Alright, now in here you guys can see one side, this side, the yellow head part is coming on top of the other circle, half circle. I want the same effect to be applied to other side as well, so it will look like an infinite loop. Okay, so physically we won't be able to do that in Illustrator. You can only have one object on top, but we can fake it using the gradients in here. Okay, so all we need to do is select this gradient in here, the one on top, and go to the gradient panel and adjust the gradient. I'm going to bring this end color towards inside and apply the same color to the end in here as well, and then select that point and bring the opacity to zero. Okay, so now the opacity will gradually go to zero in the end, so that the bottom portion will be visible like this, which will create the illusion like the object below is on top. Okay, so you guys got the idea. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to cancel that and select both of these in here, both of these shapes, and going to apply the same effect we have created earlier. Now bring the gradient point to the inwards and select the gradient endpoint and make the opacity to zero. Now we will have the same look in both ends like this. Okay, cool. Now we can make this circle a little bit smaller, and let's also make a copy in here. I'm going to change the stroke color in here. A solid color is fine. And then let's make one more copy, Alt drag. Reason for this step is because for some reason, when you have gradient in your stroke and when you apply a transform effect in Illustrator, for some reason, it's not applying properly. For an example in here, if I select this and go to the transform tool in here and apply a transform effect, you guys can see it's applying like this. Okay, this may be a bug in Illustrator, or there's something wrong with my version in here. You guys can try with your Illustrator, maybe now it has been fixed. But for now, I'm going to create this depth. I'm going to make this as a solid color and bring it into the center like our earlier version. Make sure it's centered to the artboard, and then hold on to your Alt key and make a large circle with this shape, which should cover your entire artboard. Now select both of these shapes and go to Object, in Blend, select Make Blend, which will make a blend object in here. Now we can go to Blends in Tools, and in here we can define specific steps or specific distance. I'm going to select specific distance and apply this effect. Alright, so now we are halfway there. Alright, now we need to expand this blend. Another reason I choose to apply a solid color in here, when you apply gradient to your stroke, when you try to expand them, they will try to expand the gradient as well. There is no way you can choose only objects. So that's the reason I have choose gradient in here as well. So now you can select all of them and go to Object and Expand Appearance. So which will bring you these options. We only need to select the object in here, deselect the fill, and also deselect the stroke. If you select the stroke, it will expand the gradient, which is not good. All right. Now just select OK. Next, we can ungroup these, right click and ungroup. So we will have individual circles like this in here. Inside these circles, there are two paths. All right. Now you can simply select this with direct selection tool, one side, and then we can get the gradient colors from here. And make sure in here you have applied the correct gradient type. Okay, same for the other side also. With the direct selection tool, select all these lines and press I and select the gradient from here. In here, change it to gradient along path. Okay, alright, so we have completed our first design. So in here, all we need to do is select all these lines, select everything except the background and rotate it to 45 degrees. You can select 45 degrees or minus 45 degrees for each side. And then go to the rectangle again, press on the artboard and change the size to 1000 by 1000 and center it to the artboard. And then select everything except the background and make as a clipping mask. Okay, so this is our first design. All right, so this can be used as a design, or you can also apply some effects in Photoshop, which I will show you guys in a while, to get some texture. All right, but with this design you guys can create many different designs. So that is the whole point of this. I'm going to show you some examples in here, but you guys can come up with new steps and create completely different abstract shapes. Okay, so for the second design, I'm going to go back to the 90 degree angle in here and select all these lines and go to the rotation tool in here, double click it to open, and in the rotation give a value. In here I'm going to give maybe 45 degrees. Doesn't matter how much you give, the different values will create different types of shapes in here. For this example, I'm going to apply 15 degrees. All right. Okay. Now you can see all of these shapes has been turned 15 degrees. Now all we need to do is deselect the first circle and press on Ctrl D, which will repeat our last step, which is rotating it in 15 degree angle. Okay. So we are going to repeat this step again and again by deselecting each of these circles. To deselect, hold on to the shift key and select on the object you want to deselect. Again, press on Ctrl D, which will rotate the selected objects like this. And again, deselect this one, again Ctrl D. So on, you are going to repeat this step until the last circle. Okay, so I will make this part faster, and in the end, you will get a shape like this in here. All right, cool. Now you can go to rectangle and create a rectangle with the artboard size, center it to the artboard, and then select everything and make a clipping mask. All right. Okay, so you guys can use this directly as your design based on your final work you wanted, or you can simply apply a texture which will give another cool look to this artwork. All you need to do is bring this into Photoshop, and in the Photoshop, go to the camera raw filter and apply a vignette, which will give you a dark edges like this in here, a vignette effect. And also I will apply a texture, a grain texture, which will give a nice looking texture to this artwork. You guys can play around with other settings in here as well to change colors and stuff, but for me, I'm going to stick to this basic change is fine. Alright, and the last design in here is also similar. In here, I have used the same steps as earlier, but this time I randomly select these lines and apply random values for the rotation. So the final look will be a randomized circles like this in here. Also give you a nice effects. After I finish this in Illustrator, I bring this back to Photoshop and apply the same effects as earlier you saw for the previous design. Alright guys, so with these basic steps, you guys can create so many different variations for your artwork, and you can use these design to different purposes as well, like background designs and abstract designs and stuff like that. Okay, and in here I have created another design which I placed it in here for you guys to see and get some ideas. Alright guys, thank you so much for watching. See you guys in the next video.